Hello everyone, this is Colleen Lema, angelic astrologer and spiritual consultant from angelmessenger.net, here to do your monthly angel card reading for July 2014. So we're past the halfway point of 2014 and we're getting ready to charge ahead. I'm actually really excited about this being the month of July because we have a few things going on. Numerologically speaking, it is going to be a 14 vibration month, which reduces down to a 5, and this means that there's going to be some changes. There's going to be some changes and redirections that are happening. Astrologically, we have Mars finally moving out of Libra towards the end of July or the second half of July, and it's going to be finally be moving into the next sign of Scorpio. Jupiter, which has been in Cancer actually for a while as well, is also going to be changing signs and moving into the sign of Leo. And for the whole entire month, we actually also have Saturn and Scorpio, and it's in called a quincunx or an inconjunct aspect to Uranus. Now, I know that all of that is quite an astrological mouthful, so you're going to have to go on to angelmessenger.net and read my angelic astrology article for the month of July to find out what all of these redirections and planetary changes mean for us. Now for this monthly reading, we're going to be using Doreen Virtue's Angel Tarot deck, and the special message card this month is going to come from the Magical Mermaids and Dolphins cards, also by Doreen Virtue. We have three stones of choice for your extra special message card as usual. We have lapis, which is a beautiful dark blue stone with gold flecks that relates to the third eye chakra, opening to higher intuition. We have this one I haven't used before. This is actually called Desert Rose Selenite. It's interesting. I don't even know how to describe it, but it looks like a tan stone underneath, and it's got like little white, inclusions, you know, around the stone. So desert white selenite. Actually, I'm not even quite sure what the properties of that one is. It's such a newer stone for me. And then this one is seraphinite. This one is a beautiful green stone, very like an emerald, dark emerald green stone with white inclusions in it. And seraphinite is really great at connecting with the angelic realm. So again, going by what you're drawn to for this month for the special message, we have lapis, desert rose selenite, or the seraphinite. And going back for a minute to the desert rose selenite, if we think about just selenite in general, selenite is also a very high vibrational stone that connects you with the angelic realm, so it probably is somewhat connected to regular selenite. Okay, so let's look at, or let's choose our cards for the month, and I've already meditated with the decks, and we're going to call in again our angels, guides, master guides, and teachers of the light, and we call in the archangels, the ascended masters, all of those of the highest vibration of light that can give us whatever messages, wisdom, and knowledge is in our highest and best interest to know for the month of July 2014. Okay, and actually I feel like this one here wants to be number one. I'm shuffling here a little bit more, choosing our second card for the month, which is this one. And choosing the third card for the month. Actually this one. You know, and this one here they're telling me to pull out for, well, actually, these two want to come out for kind of special message card. Special message card, kind of a sum up, I guess, sum up energy for the month. All right, so let's take a look at what we have for the month of July. We start out with the Ten of Earth, and that's interesting because we had this card not too long ago in one of the weekly angel card readings. And the Ten of Earth says, a very happy family life, financial security, and finding magic in the little things in life. So this month of July actually looks pretty good to start out because this to me is the ultimate fulfillment. The number 10, it's the last card in the tarot before we get to like the page and the knight and the queen and the king cards, so which is called the court cards. But so we have ultimate fulfillment, on the earthly plane, you know, when it comes to our projects, our career, our money, our finances, things that are tangible in nature, a lot of happiness, joy, growth, expansion, and fulfillment. We have a beautiful family here of angels, like a feminine angel, female angel, so a couple little children angel with angel wings here. So they're all very happy and joyful, kind of celebrating the fruits of their labor, celebrating the joy, the prosperity, the abundance, the manifestation and growth that has occurred for them. So let's get more information by looking at the second card. Second card is the King of Water. And at the top it says trustworthy, compassionate, respected, and cultured. At the bottom it says open your heart and mind to those around you. Trustworthy and heartfelt advice and charity work. And right away as I was reading that, they were giving me the message to open up your heart, your emotions. Get in touch with the positive emotions within your heart. Again, the joy, the happiness, the fulfillment. You know, visualizing your desires and dreams coming to fruition, because as you tap into those positive emotions, you're going to bring to fulfillment all of this prosperity and abundance. That's actually the trick to manifestation. You know, when you manifest things, you visualize, you see in your mind's eye what it is that you want to bring into existence, but you have to have that emotion connected to it, the feeling of just gratitude and love and happiness, and you know, a feeling of your every dream kind of coming true, and just really feel that down to the core. And that's what actually helps to bring into manifestation those things that you're looking to you know, bring into your life or manifest in your life. Oh, love this. Love, love, love. The Wheel of Fortune, Archangel Michael. This is Major Arcana number 10. This says a time of positive change, a situation suddenly moves forward. Fortune is on your side. Now, I have to say that, again, I've kind of felt this was going to be a turning point month since the very beginning of 2014. And the reason why was because we had that Mars retrograde in Libra for such a long time. And this month of July is when Mars actually passes the degree that it's stationed at and went retrograde in the first place. And I knew as soon as Mars, which is about our energy and forward movement, that when it passed that degree that it's stationed at a few months ago, that we were going to see finally things like charging ahead, because this is the year of the horse. Remember that Chinese year of the horse when we were supposed to have fast forward movement? This is that fast forward movement time period. This is the turning point, and this is what the Wheel of Fortune is saying. It's the turning point to positive things ahead. Now we can see things moving forward. Let's see what the extra special message cards are that both wanted to come out together. Page of Fire. Awesome. Page of Fire. Outgoing, creative, confident, mischievous. News of an exciting new endeavor. Use your originality and ingenuity. So this is telling me that good news is on the way. Good news is coming. A lot of, you might have a lot of thoughts, ideas, and plans that suddenly like start to catapult you ahead. Or you might get communication or information from an outside source, person, or organization. Or the messages might just be coming from spirit, from your guides and your angels, because this is the fire suit, and the fire suit does deal with the spiritual realm. So very, very positive message here. And the other extra special message card that came out for everybody was the Queen of Earth, another court card, which says thoughtful, creative, warm, and sensible. Make time for those around you. Take a sensible approach and deal with challenges in a kind and understanding manner. Now, the first thing that popped out to me was that we had the keyword creative here, and the Page of Fire back here also has the keyword creative. So we're talking about using our creative gifts, talents, and abilities. And you know, expand your perception of what you think creative is, because it can mean many, many things. It doesn't just mean that you can paint or draw or sing or dance or whatever. Creativity is within each and every one of us. So allow that creative energy to kind of expand within yourself and search forward. The other thing that came to mind here was that because it seems to me that we're going to have such quick, sudden movement, the Wheel of Fortune kind of suggests that, the Page of Fire suggests that, that you have to be kind of grounded. To me, the Queen of Earth is about being grounded and sensible and practical and not getting too far ahead of yourself, because the energies are going to start moving a lot faster now for the second half of the year. And we want to still make sure that we're not missing anything, that we don't skip anything, that we don't, you know, try to jump too far too fast. So the Queen of Earth is just saying to stay grounded and stable, you know, that things are, you know, moving ahead, so no worries anymore, and just kind of take your time if need be. So this is a positive month. I'm so thrilled. I'm so happy. Let's look at what your special message is, depending on what stone you chose for the month. So for those of you that chose the lapis, actually this one to me is calling for the lapis people. The lapis people, your answer is yes. So if you had a question in your mind about career, a project, a relationship, you know, something, family, moving forward on something, the answer for you this month is yes. It says your intuition is correct. Take action accordingly. There's not much more I can say about that. Listen to your inner voice. Listen to your inner guidance. Listen to you know, what the angels and your guides are telling you, and then move forward because it's the right time this month. Very, very nice. For those of you that chose the desert rose selenite, people, I'm not really seeing or feeling the card here. It's this one here. Desert rose selenite, friendship. That's interesting because I think the weekly reading for the first week of July included friendship, I believe, in its reading. But this says, make a date for play day with one or more friends. So the message for you is in this month of July, connect with people, connect with friends and family and loved ones that make you feel joyful and happy. And they're saying that that in part is not just because, although it is, you know, about spending time with those that you care about and love, but it's also about raising your vibration. Because as you play and you're connected with people that you care about, it raises your vibration. And as you raise your vibration, things fall into place much more easily. And so with connecting with those other people in your life, your projects, your plans, and other areas of your life are going to move forward that much more easily and fall into place that much more easily. Okay, and then for the seraphonite people, those of you that chose seraphonite as your stone of choice for the month of July. This one here. Blessed change. Wow, this is an awesome card. Blessed change. It says a major life change brings you great blessings. And this kind of has a mermaid, and she's kind of on the ocean floor, sort of in an upside down position. So she's looking at things from a different perspective. And a lot of times this card can mean that there's some big and dramatic change that occurs that at first might seem a little bit daunting or seem a little bit scary, or that you're not sure if that's exactly, you know, what you planned or what you wanted. But this is saying to look at it from a different perspective, just like this mermaid who's upside down, that this is a beautiful, wonderful, blessed change that's going to bring you much greatness, much prosperity, much abundance, much gratitude. You know, many, many blessings are going to come to you because of this change that's occurring in the month of July. And they're saying to me that it could actually be a physical change, which is likely, but they're also saying that it could be an energetic shift or an energetic change within you and around you that you sense and feel as you move through this month. So this was an awesome, very positive reading for this month of July. I wish you all much love and light and many, many angel blessings.